It's been called the Blood Moons Phenomenon, a remarkable series of total lunar eclipses that aligns with the feasts of the ancient Jewish calendar. Today, Jonathan continues his discussion with Pastor Mark Biltz, a best-selling author and expert on this fascinating topic. The fourth and final blood moon. Could it be a divine warning of what may be ahead? Today on Jewish Voice.
Shalom and welcome to Jewish Voice, a program to help you to understand the Jewish roots of your Christian faith, Bible prophecy, and world events surrounding Israel. The Bible tells us that God uses the sun, the moon, and the stars to communicate with us. For the last 17 months now, we have been experiencing a series of total lunar eclipses that are about to culminate on September 28th of this year. The fourth and last in a series of four blood moons is about to take place. And what makes this tetrad of lunar eclipses so unique is that they've all coincided with Jewish holidays, or more accurately, biblical feasts. In fact, key feasts known as pilgrimage feasts, Passover and Sukkot, or the Feast of Tabernacles. Now, the fourth and final one will occur the first day of Sukkot, known also as the Feast of Booths. In fact, one of the places it will be best seen is in Jerusalem, where they will be watching as they dwell in booths. Now, back to help us understand what these blood moons represent and what God may be trying to tell us is my good friend, Pastor Mark Biltz. Mark. Welcome back. Hey, we are getting close, aren't we?
Oh, we are getting very close.
In fact, I'm going to squeeze predictions out of you in just a second, but I think it's really, really fascinating how all this opens up when you go back to the biblical calendar. It makes no sense in the world calendar, in the Gregorian calendar. When you looked at those dates of the four blood moons, they didn't really mean anything, but then God gave you the key.
Yeah, that it was the key.
The biblical calendar. Talk about that more, because this is one of the great revelations I believe God is using you to bring to his people.
Yeah, thank you. It's just that our calendar is a pagan calendar formed by Julius Caesar. It was called the Julian calendar. Pope Gregory tweaked it, and it was changed to the Gregorian calendar. And it's a very scientific calendar based totally on the sun. And the Muslim calendar is based totally on the moon. It's a very great scientific calendar. But neither one of those are the one God uses. Okay, Genesis 1:14, God also says, I want to use both of them for my calendar to determine the Moedim, or to determine the feast days. And that's the one he uses. I like to tell people, if your boss tells you he wants to meet you at 4 o'clock on Friday, and if you tell him, well, that doesn't work in my schedule, how about 2 o'clock on Tuesday? You're not going to have a job for very long. Well, God has the calendar. I used to live in Garden City, Kansas. Now, unless you've ever lived in a place like this, you never have a concept of what it's like. If you live right on a time zone, Garden City was right on the time zone.
I can't even imagine living on a time zone, you know? Your neighbor's an hour ahead of you.
Exactly, and that's without traffic, you know? But you would call a neighbor and say, hey, you know, do you want to go for dinner? Yeah, whose time zone, yours or mine, you know? You know, that, and so we have to realize we need the calendar we're on. God said we're in the world, but we're not of it. And so we need our calendar, but we also need to be on God's calendar, because that's the one that he uses to communicate to us.
Absolutely, and I think the significance, as you're talking, of the final wrap-up blood moon, a super moon seen most clearly in Israel, in Jerusalem,
the grand
and being
finale
on Sukkot, which is the final ingathering.
Yes.
This is not a coincidence. This is not by accident or happenstance. This is God speaking to us.
And I believe, and I mean this in a respectful way, that I think we're entering the Super Bowl of human history. And it's the greatest time, the greatest revivals. I think the church is going to excel. I think we're going to succeed. Matter of fact, in Malachi, it talks about the enemy will be trampled under your feet. And I think a lot of people have a misconception, and they're too afraid. They need to not move in fear whatsoever.
Mark, two schools of thought. One, we're going to take, as Adam was commanded to do,
take dominion over the earth, dominion theology. We're going to present the earth to the Lord after we've totally been conquerors and victorious and conquered the earth for the Lord. The other one, doom and gloom, we run for the hills and we prepare for the worst.
I think both those are completely wrong.
I do too. Give us the scenario, the correct scenario here.
Messiah returns.
Messiah, judgment, trial, tribulation, persecution, the glory and protection of God.
Yes, I believe
the
so.
The world gets darker, the people of God get brighter and more powerful.
Think
and
of the plagues in the Exodus. There was always light in Israel's dwellings when it got dark. They didn't experience those same things.
That's right. Don't go anywhere. We're going to delve even deeper into the blood moons phenomena and the urgent message God could be sending through these heavenly events. And up next, the scattered tribes of Israel, where did they disappear to? Could some of them have actually migrated to Africa and retained their identity? You'll find out just ahead.
Here at Jewish Voice, we are dedicated to proclaiming the gospel, the good news that Yeshua, Jesus, is the Messiah, to the Jew first and also to the nations. One way we do this is by providing life-saving medical help to some of the most impoverished and needy Jewish people in the world, as we share God's love and the good news that Jesus is their true Messiah. Today, we are preparing for our next medical clinic to bless a remarkable tribe in Gondar, Ethiopia, the Beta Israel. A lovely but persecuted people who have been practicing distinctly Jewish customs for centuries. Today, we urgently need your help to equip and fund this vital outreach. Will you be a blessing to these suffering Jewish people? Time is literally running out for many of the most vulnerable there, especially infants and toddlers. Without our immediate help, some of these precious sons and daughters of Abraham may die needlessly for lack of basic medical care. But you can help save them. But we must act now. Call or click right now to share life-saving help. And we'll say thank you by sending you a powerful DVD presentation by Pastor Mark Biltz, which will deepen your understanding of the Blood Moons phenomenon. Blood Moons, Decoding the Imminent Heavenly Signs, on DVD by Mark Biltz, is our very special thank you for any gift of support today. And if God has blessed you with the means to share a gift of $100 or more to help bless some of the neediest Jewish people on earth, we'll also send you Mark Biltz's best-selling companion book, which will take you even deeper into the mysteries of God's prophetic calendar and its relationship to signs in the heavens. Plus, we'll send you Messianic Rabbi Jonathan Bernis's illuminating DVD, A Rabbi Looks at Israel, and our lovely and meaningful Israeli mezuzah. These are traditionally placed on the doorposts of Jewish homes and will serve as a powerful reminder that your home is blessed by God because you pray for Israel and have been a blessing to the Jewish people. To share a gift in support of this vital outreach and request your thank you resources, please call, click, or write now. And remember, your generous gift will make you a part of extending life-saving medical help to some very needy Jewish people. Once again, time is of the essence for many of these people. Please call, write, or click right now.
I'm back with Pastor Mark Biltz, and we're discussing four consecutive blood moons, all which remarkably have fallen on key Jewish feast days. And Mark, you've just come out with a really important, actually you came out a while ago, but we want to offer because it's so important, Blood Moons, Decoding the Imminent Heavenly Signs. Now, explain to me and others that may be thinking about the same question. Think of this. Death all around, and they're inside the blood-covered tabernacle, the blood-covered home, feasting with the Lord.
Right.
Feasting on the Lamb.
Sure.
Yeah.
Sure.
Great picture.
Oh, yeah.
Great picture.
I think that we need to move in confidence. I know there are people right now that, you know, they're already experiencing tribulation. If you're a Christian and you're in Iran or Syria or some of these places, you know, it's not real good. But see, in one sense, it's really different for me. And again, I don't expect everyone to have the same line of thinking as I have. But I've almost died so many times, I've lost count. I've had guns at my head twice, just me and the gunman. And they said they were going to blow my head off both times. And it's just me and them. and I'm still here. And major car accidents where I'm not buckled in and I roll over the length of 100 yards, a football field, and all I did was sprain my ankle. And I just really believe that if it's not my time, it's not going to happen. And if it is my time, there's nothing I can do to stop it. Right. So I stopped worrying about it, and I just want to get the job done that God has called me to do.
We occupy until he comes.
Exactly.
And we fulfill our unique mandate. I'll tell you this. Knowing what I know now and what I believe to be the times we're living in,
sure,
I wouldn't want to live at any other time in history. Because I used to think, to live in the time of Jesus and to actually hear him teach and to witness those miracles, I'd rather live right now.
Can you imagine, every one of you that are here were created for such a time as this. You could have lived any time in history, but God said, I need you to run the final lap of the baton, you know, in the track race. He's given each one of you because he knows you're the one that he needs to do the task. Why would we not want to pick up the baton and run with it?
Yes.
And the whole concept, people misunderstand waiting for the fullness of the Gentiles to come in. When the Lord will begin to build up Zion, that's when he'll appear in his glory. Mm. Well, Zion is Jerusalem. And it's the whole problem politically today is because they're building up Zion with all
happening.
The settlements since 67.
Everyone in the studio and everyone watching by the program right now at home or wherever you are, you have a divine destiny for such a time as this.
Exactly.
And I think of that word of Mordecai to his niece Esther.
Yes.
You've been called to the kingdom for such a time as this. And if deliverance doesn't come through you, God will raise up another.
That's
but it's to be through us.
That's
we're the ones that have been called for this time, at this appointed time in history.
And it uses that term set time in Psalms 102. And it even says this is being written for the generation to come. And in Hebrew, it's akaron, which means the terminal generation.
Yes, it's exciting. Now, back to the blood moon. Does this signal, do you believe, that we're entering into the tribulation? Or so is it immediate? Is it now? Will judgment happen on the day of this eclipse? What should we look for?
Well, I don't think anything is going to happen necessarily on that very day. But I think all four of these, including that one, God always wants to warn before he brings judgment. I think we could see, I mean, judgment's already is starting for that matter. But I think we're going to see, as you said, the birth pangs. They're going to get stronger. They're going to get closer. And 2016 is going to be an incredible year. I think we're going to see a lot of judgment. We got the elections at the end of 2016. So whoever is elected is the one who's going to be carrying us the next 4 years. I think God is like the master chess player. Every person's being put in position.
I think we can all agree on one thing, though. Road signs.
Yes.
An example of bridge out. You better be paying attention.
That's
or
the
you're
key.
Going to die if you don't slow down. And I think we have signs. We have road signs.
Yes.
In many areas, Israel becoming a nation, Jerusalem being restored.
Yes.
But I see these four consecutive blood moons being directly connected to road signs where God is trying to warn his people, to wake up his people, to warn the world. Get ready.
And I think the reason why, too, is because no false prophet can manipulate an eclipse. The sun and the moon are beyond anyone's control. The calendar is beyond anyone's control. So God, and they speak in every language. You don't have to, I mean, if God wants to communicate to everybody from every tribe, nation, and tongue, what better way than to use something that can speak to every language?
Yeah, good point. Good point. Now, not on your, I didn't see this on your website, but other websites, other articles talk about these eclipses affecting power sources, affecting tides in a very severe way. And any thoughts on that?
I don't know. I like sticking with facts. You know, I like sticking with the science, the history. Sure, things could happen. But I think we all need to be prepared for a few weeks, no matter what. Our government is not going to come meeting our needs. And I think we need to realize that. I mean, look at Hurricane Katrina, how long it took to get things done. So I think, and as far as like storing up food, I really believe just like the widow with one cruse of oil, if all you can afford is one can of beans, get you one can of beans. God can multiply it like he did the bread and the loaves, you know. But so for me, I don't think, again, no one should be in fear. I mean, do whatever you can do according to whatever budget you have. But for me, I have food not to hoard, but to share. Because like Joseph, when the time came, they had to come to Joseph. And I want people to come to me and get my food, and I can share the gospel with them, and God can always multiply whatever I have.
Give me your address before you leave, by the way. the most practical things that people that are watching can do? Because, and one thing I really love about your ministry is you say, I'm only presenting what I see,
yeah,
and factual, without making predictions, whether it's into the tribulation or it's 7 or 14 years or whatever, sure, from now. The biblical calendar is key, and there's signs that God is making it clear.
Right.
Look at the six-day war. Six yes. days they defeated the surrounding enemies. Yes. The seventh day they rested. Don't you see God's handprint over all this?
Totally. And to me, the biggest thing is the calendar. We've got to get on the biblical calendar, which is why we have this calendar that overlays the Gregorian with the biblical calendar. Because, I mean, we celebrate the resurrection every year. But we celebrate it when it happened. Okay? Do you know next year, now, how many of you know that Jesus, before he ascended into heaven, he had to be raised from the dead? And how many of you know before he could be raised from the dead, he had to be buried? And before he could be buried, he had to die.
1 Corinthians in reverse, 15, right?
All right, right. So, do you know next year, Christians celebrate Easter a month before Passover? How do you celebrate the resurrection a month before he even dies?
Yeah, wrong calendar. Sometimes it overlaps.
Right. Right. So I believe we need to keep the resurrection, but we need to also keep it when it happened.
Some closing thoughts. These are signs. God is speaking to us. It's a warning.
Yes.
Whether it's a month from now, a year from now, 10 years, these are warnings. What should we do?
I think that's the greatest question you could ask. And to me, the main thing is get right with God. And be praying for your family members that they get right with God. How many of us want to be warned? I always tell people, tell me, I can handle it. But let me decide what I'm going to do. And so God wants to warn all of us. But, it's a sword, but it cuts two ways. A sword can either kill you or can save your life by taking out your appendix. You know, so it just depends. And God warns because he loves us. And so I think we need to take heed to God's warning. And, we need to get right with God, number one.
Okay, most important thing, get right with God, spend time with God.
Yep, yep.
Warn family members to get right with God.
Yes.
I mean, you can't go wrong with that. I remember when Hal Lindsey's book came out, The Late Great Planet Earth, people were expecting Jesus to return back then.
Right.
He didn't come then. It's been decades, but people accepted the Lord. They got their life right with God.
Sure.
And I know what people are going to say about these programs this week. They're going to say date setting, predictive prophecy. But we're not setting a date. But what we are saying is that the men of Issachar were wise because they understood the times. And
yes.
while no man knows the date, the hour, the Bible says you'd better know the season and wake up you that sleep.
Yes, exactly, exactly. And when it says seasons, it refers to the Moedim, the feast days. That's what it's talking about. Not winter, spring, summer, fall.
Mark, I thank God for you. Mark Biltz.
Thank you.
Really important stuff. Listen, I strongly believe in understanding the times because Scripture encourages us that while no man knows the hour of Yeshua's return, we're to interpret the season and be prepared for his soon return. And
yes.
I believe that this DVD that Mark has done on blood moons, decoding the imminent heavenly signs, is more than just about blood moons. This is a resource that will help you interpret that what the Lord is trying to tell us. And I believe what he's trying to say is, get ready. These are road signs. And I encourage you to get a copy. And by doing so, you'll also be helping us to get the gospel out while there's still time.
Exactly.
That's what this ministry is all about, bringing the gospel to the Jew first and also to the nations while there's still time. Listen, Jesus himself said, I work when it's day, for night will come when no man can work. And so you'll be helping us to get out the most important news that anyone can hear, the good news of eternal life found in Yeshua, in Jesus. Next, there are many myths and legends surrounding the mysterious lost tribes of Israel. The Jewish people have been scattered throughout the nations of the world. Could some of them be living in remote areas of Africa? We'll give you the answer just ahead on Jewish Voice.
Here at Jewish Voice, we are dedicated to proclaiming the gospel, the good news that Yeshua, Jesus, is the Messiah, to the Jew first and also to the nations. One way we do this is by providing life-saving medical help to some of the most impoverished and needy Jewish people in the world, as we share God's love and the good news that Jesus is their true Messiah. Today, we are preparing for our next medical clinic to bless a remarkable tribe in Gondar, Ethiopia, the Beta Israel, a lovely but persecuted people who have been practicing distinctly Jewish customs for centuries. Today, we urgently need your help to equip and fund this vital outreach. Will you be a blessing to these suffering Jewish people? Time is literally running out for many of the most vulnerable there, especially infants and toddlers. Without our immediate help, some of these precious sons and daughters of Abraham may die needlessly for lack of basic medical care. But you can help save them. But we must act now. Call or click right now to share life-saving help. And we'll say thank you by sending you a powerful DVD presentation by Pastor Mark Biltz, which will deepen your understanding of the Blood Moons phenomenon. Blood Moons, Decoding the Imminent Heavenly Signs, on DVD by Mark Biltz, is our very special thank you for any gift of support today. And if God has blessed you with the means to share a gift of $100 or more to help bless some of the neediest Jewish people on earth, we'll also send you Mark Biltz's best-selling companion book, which will take you even deeper into the mysteries of God's prophetic calendar and its relationship to signs in the heavens. Plus, we'll send you Messianic Rabbi Jonathan Burness's illuminating DVD, A Rabbi Looks at Israel, and our lovely and meaningful Israeli mezuzah. These are traditionally placed on the doorposts of Jewish homes and will serve as a powerful reminder that your home is blessed by God because you pray for Israel and have been a blessing to the Jewish people. To share a gift in support of this vital outreach and request your thank you resources, please call, click, or write now. And remember, your generous gift will make you a part of extending life-saving medical help to some very needy Jewish people. Once again, time is of the essence for many of these people. Please call, write, or click right now. Remote areas of southern Zimbabwe, a team of 51 volunteers were joined by 120 national workers, and together they just finished one of the most challenging and rewarding Jewish Voice outreaches to date. In a week full of both work and ministry, the Lord's hand was clearly seen as Jewish Voice conducted its very first medical outreach to the impoverished Lemba Jewish community.
We've seen children who couldn't speak, they couldn't hear, they couldn't do anything. I'm shocked. And then they can speak, and they can hear, and they can say their names. Babies that there was this 18-month-old baby that couldn't even stand up or sit up, nothing. And then it had witchcraft bracelets on its wrist. They were cut off, and the baby sat up immediately. I mean, eyes to see with adults. I've seen so many miracles. My heart is just filling up. I'm forever going to be changed over this entire experience. It's the best thing that has ever happened to me.
In the afternoon, I was starting to feel pretty tired. My compassion level for patients was dropping. And all of a sudden, the nurse came into my room and said, "Can you see this patient outside?" And I said, feeling tired, "Well, can't they carry the patient into my room?" And she's like, "Well, she looks pretty sick." So I went outside, and I go up to this cart that is being drawn by two donkeys, near death look on this young female who is dying from AIDS. And I find out that she's come 8 kilometers to seek help. And it was kind of like a slap upside my head, because 2 minutes before that, I'm in my room feeling sorry for myself. And that was just God saying, how do you feel now? And I didn't know what to do. I see a dying woman, and I can't help her. But as a man of God, I can share love. I can show compassion. And that's not easy for me to do, but God working through me made it very easy.
The Lord is looking down on this with favor, and he's looking down on this that he loves culture and he loves diversity. And I had such a warm, wonderful feeling that the Lemba here are very gentle and loving people, and that the Lord has not forgotten them, and that they have retained as much as they possibly can of their culture and of their Jewishness.
Be an important part of God at work in these last days, gathering his people back to himself. We need volunteers urgently for this outreach, medical professionals, prayer partners, and practical service volunteers as we minister to thousands of very needy and spiritually hungry people in just one short week. Come with us and help these desperate Jewish people. Say yes to being God's hands and feet. Please answer the call.
Since 1967, Jewish Voice has been dedicated to proclaiming the good news that Yeshua, Jesus, is Messiah and Savior to the Jew first and also to the nations. Now, one way we do this is by helping some of the most impoverished and needy Jewish people in the world. We've been able to demonstrate God's love by providing these people with medical care, dental care, eye care, medicines, all completely free of charge. But most importantly, the gospel. And it's because of your faithful support that we're able to make a difference in their lives. But we need your help. I'm going to ask you to partner with us to help us transform lives and to bless Jewish people in need by sharing a generous gift today. Anything that you can do, no matter how much, will help. No matter how small or large, you'll be making a difference. Now, as our way of saying thank you, I want to send you today's important resources. We want to sow into your life as you help us to sow into theirs. You can call, click, or write to respond. And remember, your generous gift will be used to help some of the most impoverished and needy Jewish people in the world. Hey, by the way, we're on Facebook. You can check us out by going to facebook.com/Jewish Voice. Well, as I leave you today, I want to remind you, as I do in every program, to pray for the peace of Jerusalem. The Bible says, they shall prosper that love thee. Until next time, this is Jonathan Berners saying shalom and God bless you.
Jewish Voice is made possible by the support of friends and partners like you.